Thank you for joining us at Beer Fish Fanatics. And this episode is actually brought to you by Whisker Seeker Tackle.
So make sure you guys go to whiskerseeker.com for all your catfishing gear.
Enjoy the episode, guys.
This episode is brought to you by Kelowna Brewing Company. If you live in Eastern Iowa, make sure to swing by Kelowna Brewing Company's tap room. Amazing food and amazing craft beer. If you live in Central Iowa or in the Midwest, swing by your local supermarket and see if they carry the Kelowna Brewing Company line of beer. And also, swing by your local restaurants, local bars. See if they have Kelowna Brewing Company's on tap. If not, make sure you guys request it. I kid you not, you won't regret that. Other than that, enjoy this episode, guys. Is it too loud? Are you guys good? How's the volume on everybody's headphones?
You're too loud.
Shit. Well, that's just because...
Still too loud.
Maybe I should just turn the headset down.
I'm with you.
All right.
Thank you.
All right, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Beer Fish Fanatics. This is Grandy, and today, a little bit different. I don't have my co-host. Fishing Kit is...
He died. That's what I heard.
I think he's still alive, but anyways... Miss you, Kit. Cheers. I'll pour one for you. He's actually super, super sick, I think. I don't know. Or he's just lazy. One or the other.
Or he's fishing.
He's fishing.
Yeah.
Dude, if I see a picture of you posting that you're fishing, Kit, I'm going to be a little upset.
I'll be proud.
Touche. Touche. Just so everybody knows. So today, I have a couple super special guests, and this is going to be a little bit different today. I wanted to do this episode because I wanted the other side, the viewpoints of the other side. And when I say the other side, I meant females. And somehow I coerced my wife to actually join me on the podcast. No, I didn't run out of guests. A lot of people are probably thinking that. But no, I actually convinced her because she doesn't like recording. She doesn't like speaking really any, I don't know. Right? Something? No, you can talk a little bit. You can enunciate, but it's okay. How you doing? I got my wife, Hugh. Hugh, say hi.
Hi.
How you doing today?
Fine.
Jeez. It's going to be tough. This is going to be a tough episode.
Guys. I don't think it'll be that tough.
And then our other special guest. So everybody who doesn't know, go check out Spencer. River Certified. We have him here, but then I think even more special than him, we actually...
Way more special.
That's what I was saying. We actually have his wife, Ella. Thank you for joining us.
Hello. Thanks for having me.
Thank you for spending the time to kick it with us. And we're at the Lazy Horse, so it's not Crazy Horse. They changed the name. It's at the Lucky Horse here in Central Iowa. You guys get an opportunity. Come swing by here. They got some pretty good burgers, good fries, and good beer on tap. So
they changed it from the Crazy Horse to the Lucky Horse, but they still have Crazy Horse on their glasses.
I don't know. I'm gonna have to ask them because I think it had to be a copyright thing, maybe.
Maybe. That's interesting.
I'm guessing.
It's news to me.
I'm guessing. Sorry.
Hope everybody's as interested as I am.
Probably. We're gonna have to ask them. So at the end of today, we will find this out, and I'll find it out.
Deal.
Why they changed the name? But cheers, guys. And then they already took a drink before I did. But it's all good.
Ooh, this is good. This is really good.
So I'm drinking.
What is it? It's an old fashioned.
You should try it.
Yeah. So what they have here, if you guys ever get a chance, if you're in Central Iowa, they have it's an old fashioned, like a, it's not a smoothie, but like a slushy. Slushy. That's it.
It's not bad.
Yeah. It's actually pretty good. And then I'm drinking the Confluence IPA. What do you got, guy?
I got a Gable. In memory of the man, the myth, the legend.
Obviously, you know, this gentleman is a big wrestler. So
Once was. Yeah.
Do you wrestle anymore at all?
I was in the room like 3 weeks ago, high school room.
Oh.
And I'm out of shape.
How'd you do against the kids?
I mean, they're kids.
Well.
But I am very out of shape.
It's all right. My wife can attest that I'm probably busy. Wow. She's shaking her head yes. So for our listeners that can't see, she's shaking her head yes. But anyways, we'll get into this. So I really wanted to get the wives on here. And the reason being is because, you know what? Fishing Kid and myself, we always talk fishing. We always talk about how, from the men's perspective, the guy's perspective, we've never actually ever had a wife or significant other that probably doesn't fish as much as we do or talk as much as that. So I just want to...
Have you had any women on the podcast?
I've had. Yeah. We've actually had some amazing women on the podcast. So if you guys tell... We've actually had like Christine Fisher. She's like one of the best.
Best. Well, she won Angler of the Year, didn't she?
Kayak fisherman. We had
Midwestern native from. I think she's from Nebraska.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Look at this guy. He knows.
Well, she's all over. It's not like hard to figure out if you pay attention to fishing at all.
She's badass.
She on the men's circuit too?
Yeah.
But she's doing the boat circuit and kicking ass on there too. Oh, I'm pretty sure.
I have no idea. I just followed her on the kayak. Yeah. I know she won. Like you say, Angler of the Year. That's pretty badass. She beat out all the men, like
all men, all women, all everybody.
Yep, that's how good she was. And we had her on the podcast. We had April Vokey. She's pretty big in the fly fishing.
You had April Vokey on here. How have I not seen this one?
Thanks for listening to our podcast.
I do listen to your podcast.
I appreciate that. I did. We actually had April.
I listened to her podcast too.
She's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. So she's a huge fly fisher woman, and she's from Australia. Originally, she's from Canada, but she lives in Australia now. But she's awesome fly fishing. She's like top notch. So that she's the one who kind of convinced me to get into fly fishing.
Really. Okay. So, I could see that.
So she got me into that. But yeah, we've actually had, let me try and think of any other. Yeah, we actually had a few other women to join us.
Cool.
So you guys aren't the first.
Now we have a few more.
Yeah, we have a few more. Yeah. But you guys are going to be the ones that I really wanted to hear you guys' opinion of being the spouse of somebody who loves fishing and the pros and cons, the ups and downs, and the good times, the bad times. I don't know. Something like that.
It's a pretty generic question, Randy.
Okay. I don't know if that was a question. All right, we'll start here. Tell me, okay, so if anybody doesn't know, if you watch my YouTube channel, maybe you've seen her, maybe not. But if you don't know, my wife, she has her, I guess you can say, happy days when it comes to my fishingness. Or not.
That's only when you catch.
Wow.
Ooh, nice. Not many happy days.
Good times, guys. Man, that's rough. Rough crowd.
I've watched you catch walleyes with my eyes.
You watched me catch a walleye.
We filled the cooler. It was a team effort. We got it done.
He's making me feel really good right now.
Yeah.
I caught one. But.
No, we filled the cooler. Dinner got brought home.
There you go. Yep. She's laughing, but she's like, damn, that walleye tasted good.
Thanks, Kit. Not you.
Or Spencer.
Kit did not catch any of those walleyes.
Oh, no. Kit actually dissed us that day, by the way.
He did. And blanked, and we limited out.
Thank you very much.
Yep.
We. But let me ask you guys. So this is the thing. Your husbands love to fish. So let me ask you first, like, or Ella, you jump in. What's the one thing that annoys you the most about me loving fishing so much? What's one thing that you'd be like, God damn it, or son of a, quit doing that? Or what annoys you the most about me loving fishing so much?
Not catching.
Wow. So you're saying you would love me to go fish all the time if I catch all the time?
Sure.
I can fish all the time if I catch?
No.
Well, you just said sure.
I don't know.
What the? Now you mix.
You
signals.
Almost got to go fishing all the time.
I just got to catch.
Yeah.
I swear I heard that.
We're going bait fishing.
What's the one thing, Ella, that I guess you can say annoys you the most when Spencer goes fishing or just having a person that loves fishing so much?
I think I know, and I'm curious if it's going to line up. If it does, I'm going to celebrate for no reason, just for being right.
if we're just talking about like just annoyances, probably that he smells like fish.
Got it.
All the time. So,
cause I'm catching.
It's all rough. Touche. But the thing is, he catfishes a lot, obviously. That means he's getting slimed a lot. He's not catching little baby ones that, you know, his hands might smell.
If the catfish aren't the problem. It's the shad.
That's very
true. I can't eat. She's right. Shad smells like shit.
Yeah, it does. Cats love it.
And Skipjack.
They're just like, let me eat that poop. Just hoover it up. No big deal. Yeah, Skipjack. I don't know if you ever dealt with Skipjack herring. They're like shad on steroids as far as being disgusting. Yeah, they eat shad, and they're basically a big shad. So anything that eats shad kind of smells like shad, like white bass and hybrids when you cut them open. But then you have a shad, that pretty much a shad that eats shad, and it's like twice as much shad.
It's real shaddy.
Pretty shaddy. Pretty shaddy situation.
That's pretty shaddy. I'm actually super surprised. I thought she was going to be like, I'm sick and tired of having boxes delivered to the front door every day.
Oh, yeah. I didn't think about that.
I'm surprised that you didn't say that. Because that's the very first thing that, because I talk to a lot of, well, I don't talk to a lot.
I buy a lot of stuff, but I don't buy, like, just outrageous amounts of things.
Do I?
Shit. Amazon notifies me.
Actually, my last big purchase, you told me to do it because I was on the fence and you're like, just get LiveScope.
Oh my God. Can I get LiveScope, honey?
I don't know what that is.
Don't worry about it. Yeah.
It's not a big deal.
It's not.
It's a small expense.
It's a necessity if you're a fisherman.
I mean, if you want to keep up with the current trend of fishing and be catching all the time.
Right.
It's pretty beneficial.
God, wait, I don't even know what to say. My wife's like, dude, you don't catch enough. I'm still...
That's why you need LiveScope.
See? Don't worry about the cost. Yeah. It's just the results.
Okay.
That's what you should be concerned about. But, no, I'm actually surprised because a lot of people are like, all the boxes that comes delivered. I mean, I guess I do order more than I need to. I think I'm that guy. Like, I see somebody orders stuff or has stuff. Like, I need that. And I realize I don't. But then it's nice to have. But does it help me catch more fish? Obviously, my wife's... Thank you.
Yeah.
Tell me how you really feel.
I like her.
All right. Well, Kit couldn't be here today because he's actually... Honestly, he's under the weather. So hopefully feel better, brother. I'll drink a beer for you. But he did want to ask a question. So, Ella... Does Spencer need permission from you as the wife to go fishing?
Every single time.
You have the floor if you want to elaborate on that. Or are you waiting for my reaction?
I was waiting for your reaction.
Well, how would you like me to react? Do I have permission to react?
There's no permission granted. I mean, we have conversations about trips, like... longer trips, you know, that kind of stuff. And I often forget, but yeah, there's no permission or anything like that.
It's a good relationship. I mean, this is the thing with, I mean, all right, she might, all right, don't hold back, all right, FYI. If I say anything wrong, I love you. You're beautiful today, by the way. If I say anything wrong, I apologize in advance. But I don't actually really ask for permission either. I think you're right on that. I just tell her so she knows where I'm at. I think that's the biggest thing, right?
That's kind of surprising because I would think that with kids, that would be a little bit more of a, you know, permission type of situation.
To me, it'd be more of a coordination type situation.
You're spot on because we have four kids and it is because, but I kind of know the schedule.
Yeah.
So I kind of know like, okay, do I have something or do the kids have something going on here? Or do we need to plan something for this day or tomorrow or whatever the case or this evening? Right. And most of the time I go, no. And I think she's going to be home. I'm like, I'm going to go fishing. Is that cool? Is that permission?
No, to me, that's like checking to make sure you didn't forget something, which I do regularly because I'm aware that well, whatever, awareness, whatever. I get a million things going through my head all the time. And then sometimes things slip through the cracks. And sometimes those are things that are a big deal, you know, and I forget stuff. So I'll double check and make sure I'm not forgetting anything. And then I coordinate whatever, or not coordinate, but just say, these are my plans. Am I missing anything? Or is there something I'm overlooking? And sometimes there is, sometimes there isn't. And if there isn't, then I'll go do what I wanted to do, or was planning on doing. And if I forgot something, then I need to change my plan.
Yeah, I think coordination is a good word for it.
Because I'm on the water a lot. Like I was on the water 250 days this year. I guess that's more than a normal work.
I'm 100 days behind you, minimum. Mom, just saying.
150 days on the water is a lot.
I wasn't on the water 150 days. I'm more than 100 days behind you.
Easily.
But where was I going with this?
I don't know. Sorry, I interrupted. Shit.
Well, happened. And I'm not very smart, so these things just leave my brain. But basically, coordinate stuff. I'm on the water a lot, and I don't know. That's all I remember.
I mean, because that was always a thing. Because I talked to, I have a lot of friends who are husbands, and the wives, honestly, is kind of crazy. Like they have to ask permission to go places.
But do they have to ask permission to watch TV?
I would think not.
Right. So I guess my thought process is, if you have time to watch TV for 3 hours, you have time to fish for 3 hours.
Well, and let's think about the permission thing, because thanks for that.
I'm here for you.
Because I think that, you know, permission might be a perspective too, because we're talking about, you know, from our perspective, it's a coordination. But if that's not thought of as a coordination, it could easily be.
The mic just decided to slowly fall.
I broke it.
That was awesome.
Yeah, no, I think it, you know, coordination could easily turn into permission if you're not on the same page.
But if you have to ask for permission, then it becomes a control thing.
Agreed.
And
is that the line? Is control?
If I had to ask you permission to do everything, then I feel like you are controlling everything I do.
No, but I'm talking about, when does coordination become permission? Is it the control?
I think it's the intent.
Keeper.
I think it'd be the intent.
Yeah.
You can word it however you want, but if you're just trying to coordinate plans, so, you know, you're being considerate of the other person and being considerate of what they want, then to me it's coordination. And that's from well-intentioned place. And then it's, to me, that's cool. But if you have to ask permission, then it becomes a control thing, and it's why does that person need to be in control? To me, that's not healthy.
Well, and yeah, I mean, being in control of someone else's life that's kind of, I don't know. I think it just gets more complicated. I mean, we don't have kids, so.
Oh, yeah.
I don't really.
But no, this is a good conversation. And the reason being is because I do want other. So this is the thing. Our listeners are 100% male. Our listeners are 100% fishermen, but I'm pretty damn sure most of them have a significant other that could probably listen and understand that. It's, you know what I'm saying?
Who lets them go fishing sometimes.
Why is it gotta be a let?
that's what I'm talking about.
You know
about
what I mean?
I hear that all the time. When we're out with people.
I guess I say that.
Yeah.
I don't really mean it. True, Ma?
Maybe.
I say it all the time. I go, yeah, he lets me go fishing. I say it all the time. I better ask boss. But I say it in the, so just so you guys know, I'm just fucking joking.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not being really serious. I'm bowing down to her and I have to really pray and ask that I can go fishing or not. But I just say in the joking manner. But I think a lot of people don't have that. And it's more than a lot of people know. I actually talked to some people I can't go fishing. What do you mean you can't go? What else are you doing? Oh, I gotta just stay home and, like you just said, watch TV or just be there. You could be outside and fishing.
Right. And even if you're there, to me, well, we talked about that, being there and being present
Very true.
Oh, it's totally different.
It's totally different. Like, just because you're in the room at the same time doesn't mean you're together, in my mind, like, in your mind. And we've talked about that, too. Like, if you're there watching, one of you's watching TV and one of you is, like, editing a video, like what we have happened times. Right, but to me, that's not being together.
Agreed.
Right.
Very true.
But this is, I mean, we're kind of getting into, like, you know, this is something that we've like, worked out within our relationship.
Yep.
Like, what kind of time we value and how much of that time we need.
Yep.
And I think that those were just really important conversations.
You ever get yelled at for fishing too much?
By who?
By your wife.
I can't think of really very many times you've yelled at me at all.
Wow.
I'm not really a yeller.
No, you're not. You don't get mad, you're just disappointed.
Damn, that makes it worse, though. I'm not going to lie. I would rather have you yell than...
Are you a yeller?
I think it depends. With four small kids.
So let's rewind this real quick. So we've been married how many years?
Like 13 and a half.
So just put this in perspective. How many years you guys been married?
Five.
And how many kids? We got
four.
Shit, I should know that. I better know that.
He was testing you.
I was testing you.
I know.
Great question. And just to put it in perspective, so everybody knows, I have no idea where the hell I was going with that right now.
It's just different when you have kids and don't have kids. That's a big one we can get into. We don't have kids that would, if we had a single child, not talking about four, we're talking about one, that would totally change the way our relationship works and how I go about doing things and you go about doing things. And the coordination would be much, much more significant because there's another person to, like, take care of. And we have a dog, but you can throw a dog in a kennel if you have to. You can't throw a 2-year-old in a kennel. It's frowned upon most places.
No, but Granny's pretty good about, like, when he goes fishing. And the other biggest thing is that because I work at the hospital and I'm on call. So basically,
that would be another big difference.
I just want to make sure the kids are covered regardless. Mm-hmm. Like, if I'm gone, the kids are being watched for, he can do his thing and come back.
Mm-hmm.
Or he can take two kids with him and do his thing.
Now, because the two other ones are big enough that I can actually take them fishing and ice fishing. They love ice fishing too. So it helps. I want to say the last year has been easier because I can take the two bigger kids, at least whether it's open water or just ice fishing. And then next year, that's why I said I should get a boat.
So no, I can take the kids.
And live scope?
And,
yeah.
Let's get a boat.
Wow, Ella.
Should go catfishing more too.
Boom.
Because if you catfish, you can just throw rods out and then go do stuff with the kids while you're waiting for a bite. Go look for arrowheads. You could go, like, bird watching. You could go try to find, like, mushrooms and then wild asparagus and stuff like that and be a forager.
I think we're going to have to get Spencer to go with the kiddos, man.
Yeah, I'm pretty cheap, too.
You're hired.
He is a guide, by the way, everybody. Go check him out. He is a guide. He's a fishing guide.
Yep. And we can go foraging on your guided trips, too, if you want. Bring your kids.
Yeah. No, but, I mean, it's kind of cool that you guys... So, in other words, I just want to get this right. You guys aren't too angry that we like the fish, technically. I think a lot of, I don't know, the feedback I get from other men that their wives just, or their significant other, just hate them being happy fishing. So, technically, you guys don't hate that. You just want to make sure that you're saying coordination and communication, correct?
I feel like alignment, like, you know, make sure that we're in alignment with what we need, you know, out of our relationship and things like that. And I think when we're out of alignment, that's when we have discussions.
You sound like a chiropractor.
Yeah.
Especially like shit.
I mean, the biggest thing is like what your intentions are and where you're coming from. You know, I want you to be happy. I want our relationship to be the best it can be. But I also want to be able to do the things that make me happy. and I want you to be able to do the things that make you happy. So the best way we can coordinate all of those things, the happier we both are, and it's a win for both of us.
Yep.
Yeah.
You're kind of quiet over there, buddy.
Buddy.
So this is very true, though. I don't get yelled at too often when I go fishing. I think it was the biggest thing. Like, hey, I'm telling her where I'm going to be, what I'm going to do, coordinate the shit, whatever the case may be with the kids. Is that just a bunch of fluff then that we see on social media all the time about men having issues?
No, I don't think so.
You think it's actually true?
I think there's some, and I think there's some people who make it into a bigger deal. There are some people I know who are in relationships, and their spouses, for whatever reason, seem to... Let's see how I can... This is going up a slippery slope here. From the actions on both ends of the party, there seems to be control issues. Like, or there has to be... One person has to have control over the other in some capacity. Why? The motivations? I don't know. It probably varies. But that's just the outside looking in. And I think there's probably times where one person wants to take control back and the other person wants to be in control. And that conflict leads to... escalated emotions. And I could be totally wrong because I'm not a psychiatrist. I'm just a dude who fishes a lot.
The ex-science teacher.
I was a junior high science teacher, which means I have a 13-year-old understanding of most things involving science.
And emotions.
Yes, 13-year-old understanding, which means I have no understanding because the emotions were all over the place.
So, how often do you fish, Ella?
Oh, not very often.
How often do you fish? When's the last time you touch a pole, bud?
It's been a few years.
Okay.
But I could still outfish you.
I don't believe it.
We'll see.
Calling you out.
Man.
You'll see.
I asked one question. She gave me another answer. That was awesome. Love it. The shit talking begins. I love it. Cheers.
Yeah, cheers.
I've seen Grandy fish. You give him a hard time. I don't think he's that bad.
Maybe he's gotten better.
Maybe.
I have my moments.
Maybe fishing kit taught you a thing or two.
Look, him and Spencer give me some tips here and there. All right. I've gotten better over the years. I get that. I can catch a fish. I can feed the family once in a while.
That is one perk about your hobby.
Walleye fillets.
Walleye.
Yeah.
Like, period.
Yeah.
Those are the best.
You probably wish I'd start fishing for crappies more.
Yes.
She's a crappie fanatic. I love crappies too. I love walleye, but crappies is like still number one for me.
My
really?
Thing with walleyes is crappie and walleye are very similar in taste. But it's so much easier to clean a walleye. You don't want to spend a half hour flaying out a limit of crappies when you can spend 8 minutes flaying out a limit of walleyes.
You want another beer? I'll take another one.
I'll take another Gable.
Yeah. But walleyes, you know what? I wanted to say thank you to Spencer. I know it doesn't mean much, but the tips that when I fish with you, whatever, that you guys, even you and Kit.
When you watch me catch all those walleyes?
Pretty much.
Yeah.
But you guys kind of explain what you guys were doing.
Yeah.
And I, honestly, I go out there and just kind of repeat it and see if it, you know.
Dude, I've been doing that my whole life. Yeah. That's, you just described learning.
Hence the teacher.
Yeah.
But no, it's true though, because I just kind of copy and then just ask, you know, what you did to make it successful in a way. And to me, it's like, that's why you're saying I was catching a couple more. I'm getting a little bit better here and there. It's honestly just because time on the water, obviously. But number two is just like kind of asking people who are better than you at shit.
Yeah.
And that's how you get better. And that's why I told, and this is the thing, because I started recording YouTube. We'll get into this in a second, too. But I started just recording me fishing and then with the kids or whatever. And I was telling you, like, this is how I'm getting better, honestly. It's like just recording my shit and then just kind of talking to people, going out with people. And then I can teach my kids to get You know what I'm saying? Like, I really, that was my biggest thing in my YouTube. The thing is, like, number one, to record shit when me and my kids are around.
Mm-hmm.
But on top of that, it's like to get better at something that I can teach them.
Sure.
Because I'm, honestly, I'm just as bad as any other
weekend. If you don't let him fish more, you're going to raise shitty fishermen. Do you want to be the mother of crappy anglers?
No.
Yeah.
So that means you're just going to have to let me go out a little bit.
Fine.
It's not even like.
You're going to have to coordinate it.
Yes,
more.
We're going to have to coordinate it. I was gonna say that. Just going to have to coordinate a little bit better. Let me see. Kit had another question he wanted to ask.
Hugh, what was your last fishing trip? You want to describe that? I'm curious.
Real?
It's been 2 years.
That you touched a rod.
Yeah, and you went fishing.
It's been longer. Did you actually touch a rod?
What's the last fish you caught?
Ice fishing?
A trout? In Colorado?
Mm-hmm. So back to this last year. This last year started guiding, which means I'm fishing with other people as a job, but I'm still fishing with other people. And then I have all my buddies who want to go, and I want to go with them. Just didn't leave a whole lot of time for me to fish by myself. And I fish by myself less this last year than I have ever in my whole life. And so this year coming up, I'm going to make a point to spend some time by myself out on the water a little bit more often. And if you want to go fishing more this year, that would make me very happy. But I'm still going to put along that time to fish by myself.
So let me ask you too, what would it take for us to get you girls to come fish with us more?
I'll cook for you.
Sold.
That was easy.
Sold. All
right. No, I just, if we could bring the kids along and have fun convincing Nova.
Kids and food.
Our third youngest.
She's like, I hate fishing.
She
it's
doesn't
boring.
Like fishing.
Mm. If you can She's change boring. Her mind.
What if you went to a place that other things? You go to, well, one of your favorite little local lakes has a frisbee golf course. As a playground.
That's a hit.
Yeah.
We could possibly do something like that.
There's several. That's one nice thing about the little lakes in Iowa. There's several small lakes that have, you know, stuff for families to do. It's not strictly fishing. And if you can accommodate all those interests into one central location, then I feel like that's still a win.
So you say entertain the kids somehow. And what was the other one?
Food.
The hell?
A lot of them have grills even there.
Yeah, don't worry about that. Got you on that one.
Yeah.
So what would it take for you, Ella, to go fishing a little bit more? What would it take? Because, and this is the thing.
I think I know the answer to this one, too.
And the reason why I ask this is because I think a lot of men always like, I wish I could have, you know, my wife with me or significant other who just loves fishing. As much as I do, is passionate about that, or just to go out with them. What would it take you to go out more if you want to go out more?
I mean, I don't love fishing, so that's not gonna change.
That's awesome. No.
But I do like it sometimes. So I think that the difference is that I don't have the attention span for fishing like he does. So he basically needs to accommodate me like you would a kid. Like with That's, short periods of time.
No.
Snacks. I need to
snacks
be comfortable.
Snacks are good. Yeah.
Like all of those basic things that you would provide for a kid.
You like, can agree with that, right?
I totally.
Okay, so that you're just being nice saying I just need to provide food and take care of the kids. In other words, I have to somewhat keep you entertained because this is not your first love. I mean, wait, let me take that back.
You're her first love.
Yes. This is not your true, fishing is not your real true love. So for you to go and do something that we truly love, there's got to be something in there for me, in a sense, to...
Yeah, there needs to be something else. Like, I have more fun when we go camping.
Yeah.
Because there's... You know, I can walk around in the sandbar. I can, like, go, I don't know.
Like, you can move the mic up in there.
Am I too quiet?
No, you're fine. It was just skip. It kept. There you go.
Oh, gosh.
Perfect.
It's a little intense. I just like going off and doing my own thing. Like I feel like sometimes when we go fishing and we're kind of stuck in one place, I feel a little claustrophobic and a little.
Do you feel that way? The reason why I'm asking,
she's looking at it from a different perspective. Like there's been a handful of times we went fishing and we're literally in the middle of freaking nowhere, miles and miles and miles away. And to get away involves a real investment of time, energy, and resources. Gotcha. Just to get back to your vehicle. And then I can totally see why you would feel trapped in that situation. And I mean, you're relying on me to get you back too. On top of that, I could totally see that. Now, I'm a fishing guide, so if anybody wants to book a trip, not every trip is like this, okay? You won't be trapped with me the way Ella feels trapped with me. So we've went to hard to get to places. It would not be quite like that if you were to book a trip.
But it makes sense. No, I know where
thanks, Ella, for that one.
I know where you're coming from, though, because I think you feel like, the thing is, when you go fishing, you're like, all right, if the fish doesn't bite within 10 minutes, you're over it in a way.
Yeah, because I think the kids lose their attention span. They're like, so
do the kids
next?
Or do you?
You.
Or both.
Let's say the kids aren't there. Let's say the kids are watched by grandma or Yaya or whoever. Now, me and you are fishing on the bank, whatever the case may be. And then if we don't get a bite in 10 minutes.
Wait, how are you the better fisherman if you...
Right?
Or sorry, right. Angler. Better angler if you're calling it quits after 10 minutes.
Right. No, I haven't been fishing in a while.
Do you get on a hot streak and ride it out and then be like, I'm better? And then if you don't get on the hot streak, you just quit fishing. So there's no way for you to not be a better angler.
So this is the bullshit thing.
That's not, I mean...
No, this is the thing. Every time I go with her, and this is the honest truth, I don't know what the hell it is. I call it the feed bullshit luck, because her last name is a fee. It's bullshit to me. So every time we go fishing, like, what the? She just gets a bite. She just gets action within the first 10 minutes. It's okay. Weird. So weird, because she doesn't fish very often.
Should take her flathead fishing then.
Right. Then she'll be like, I'll never go again after 10 minutes.
Probably.
That's the thing. But usually we
muskies.
Well, I never got one.
I'm trying to think of all the hardest fish to catch.
I've never caught. Those are the two that I've never caught. So there you go. But I haven't had the time to spend to try to catch those two, though. So that's the thing. But no, the thing is with her, she's like 10 minutes in, done. Because usually she's always catching within, or at least getting some type of action. So it's the entertainment factor to keep you entertained in a way, right? I guess. I don't know. You tell me.
A lot of staring happening right now.
I know. She's looking at me like...
Well, you brought on two people that are not comfortable on camera or recorded. So this is kind of what you get.
You should ask questions, Ella. You're good at that.
I mean, I don't have anything
ask
to ask.
Ask me a question.
Right now.
There you go.
You put me on the spot.
Sorry.
Gosh.
It happens. It's not bad. You guys are actually doing okay.
I have a question. Ella, now that you've conquered the sturgeon, what's the next fish that you would like to catch?
I mean, I like...
And if you say carp, we're divorced. Just like that.
I like catching things that I've never caught before. Like, I think what I do like about fishing is like the... what most people don't like. I just like the fish. Like, I like to, like, see it and, like, hold it and, like, look at it. Like,
squish it.
Yeah, I just think they're really... I just think they're really cool. So, the catching, like, a new one would be really cool.
Well, is
like
there a new one that you know of that you want to catch?
Well, burbot. Burbot okay. would be kind of cool. Okay. Salmon would be cool. Like, really anything. Even those, like, even little fish. Like, we're talking about microfishing.
Gross.
I know. But, like, I'm okay with, like, you know, we could find a compromise there. But.
Well, let me know when you go for burbot fishing. That's a species that Fishing Kid and myself are trying to knock off our list.
They're cool-looking fish.
Dude, well, technically, are they fish?
Yeah. They are a freshwater cod.
There
Yeah.
So they taste good too.
They apparently are delicious.
I heard they're like one of the best eating fish out there. So, well, they kind of look like an eel.
They're also difficult to catch consistently is what I'm...
Unless you go to Minnesota, it seems like they catch it through the ice, at least YouTube shows it all.
Yeah. Yeah, I make a little flyheads look real easy.
Yeah, you do. It's true though. You do. You make. I'm like, man, how hard could it be to catch a flathead? It's sorry. It's hard.
It is fucking hard. I'll say that.
Like, I've never caught one my whole life. I'm like, hey, but you have to have patience.
You can do it all perfect. You got to have some patience. I average one every 6 hours this year, and that's the best I've ever done. The first year I did it was like one every 45 hours.
It's location though, yeah.
I mean, it's everything. The better you do it all, the more you're going to catch. Like, some things are prioritized more, but it's not just any one thing.
Is that what it's like with other fish, too? Except you have more walleye or more...
Oh, absolutely. You know, I mean, water level, time of year,
yeah,
bait preferences, location, and then spot on the spot. Like, you have different types of habitat, but you have, like, higher percentages of areas within that specific type of habitat, and which varies based on water level and time of year. And then you have general bait preferences that vary based on time of year.
So flathead are just unique because there's fewer of them and their feeding habits are different.
I don't even know if their feeding habits are different. There's just not as many of them.
Do you think down south has, obviously, it seems like south has a lot more.
It's all, but you're basing that off of stuff you see, media you see online. Like, that's the beautiful thing about YouTube. Like, I can paint whatever picture I want. I can tell whatever story I want. And if I want to make it look like I struggled, I make it look like I struggled. If I want to make it look easy, I make it look easy. Most of the time, I just try to condense it down in something that's entertaining and to keep people watching it for the longest amount of time while telling a story. And sometimes it comes out in that story that makes it look easy. Sometimes it doesn't. So the stuff you're looking at, maybe it is really better, maybe it isn't. Like, but with that being said, there are bodies of water in certain locations down south where the flathead population is substantially better than ours. But a lot of that boils down to habitat availability. Like, they just have way more flathead habitat in those places, so they have a larger fish population, and therefore at different times of year, you're gonna, and if you nail all those things together, you're gonna have amazing fishing.
That just means I just gotta fish all the time.
That's what I suggest everybody does.
Would you fish all the time if you could?
You think you put in 250 days on the water?
If I could? I mean,
when it was 38, it rained 4 inches and there was a lightning storm and I was running a guide trip.
If I could, yes. And if I could take my, this is how much I actually really love fishing. And if I could take my kids more often than not, yes. I mean, depending on the situation, obviously. Yeah, I would. It's so hard to explain. I mean, you catch a fish. You've caught a fish, a major, like you were just saying, you caught the sturgeon, like, amazing. To me, like, catching a fish, it was just like, it's just hard. You can't explain it until you do it yourself. And depending on what species of fish you catch, I don't know. I get excitement even catching a bluegill. I know you don't.
You don't know me.
I do. You don't get excited.
Well, you know, he does.
Called me out.
Because his eyes are like, shit, this is the best bait ever.
I see a bluegill and I'm like, okay, I got to catch 49 more to fill the bait tank.
But
doing my chores.
I get excited. I get super excited. And then when my kid, when I see the my kid's expression when they actually catch it. So I do get super disappointed when I take them and they're like, fudge, we don't catch shit. It's like, sucks. Because I see their face like, they get over it in about 15, 20 minutes. But when they catch a fish, like, they're like super excited. So if I get the opportunity to give those moments to them, because everything goes away. When I say everything goes away, anything from the tablets, everything from the TV, everything from life in a way.
That's sweet.
Goes away. Not just from me, from the kids,
everything goes away. They're just at, they're in that moment. So that's why I love fishing so much. So people ask, like, why do you like to go so much? I'm like, because the moment that your rod or whatever line goes down, everything disappears. You're, that's it. You're in that moment. And that's the one thing that I try to explain to people. Like, I explain to her, I go, it's just hard to explain, but everything goes away. I'm just focused on that. And then when I see my kids' faces, everything goes away. They're just in that moment.
That sort of like presence, you were talking about, like how fishing is meditative for you too.
Oh yeah.
And I wonder if it's, you know, for similar reasons.
It's meditative to me, not necessarily the catching aspect, but just the problem solving aspect. Like I go out there and feel like I'm trying to put together a puzzle. And that process of trying to put together that puzzle is therapeutic in a way. Whether I catch something or not, like you either, I mean, Conor McGregor's quote, you win or you learn. And that's kind of how I feel about fishing.
Very true. But, and that's why, I don't know who's going to listen to this episode, but I do want other women to actually listen to this episode. It's because if they want to hear from at least my perspective, it's like, that's it. That's the reason why it's euphoric. When you can, I mean, to me, when I catch a fish, like, holy shit, it's euphoric to me at that moment. And it's like, there's nothing that I don't know how to explain it. It's just euphoric in a way. That moment when you catch a fish and you land it, it's like, especially when you start hitting the, you know, PB, like personal best fish, then all of a sudden it's just like, holy, you can't take a smile away from my face all of a sudden. And that's the biggest thing, and that's why I went. So, because women always ask, like, why do you like fishing so much? Why, you know, or I have other wives or other, I get knocked on. Like, why do you love fishing so much? I'm like, it's just, I try to explain it, and then they don't get it.
But that seems kind of odd, because, like, a lot of people have hobbies. You know, yeah. Why do you like watching TV? Why do you like woodworking? Why do you like, you know, whatever your hobby is?
But I think people will only feel, or that's their point of view, and then like you just say, you explain it to them, but they're just like, whatever, they're still gonna look this way, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I think the description of catching a fish might be the thing that misses with people, because like fishing, you bringing up other hobbies kind of reminded me of the thing that I really love about fishing. It's not so much, as cliche and dorky as it sounds, it's not catching the fish is the thing that I enjoy. It's just the act of figuring it out, being out there and then solving that puzzle while I'm on the water. And then when you catch a fish, it's like when you put that puzzle piece, you find the spot for your puzzle piece, you know. And the act of catching a fish is fun, but it's not the most rewarding part. It's not the part that I enjoy. Like, that's not the number one thing I enjoy when I'm out there.
Very cool. No, I mean, I think it goes a long way, because like you're just saying, it's just the walk. Sometimes you walk a mile. Sometimes you just...
Sometimes you walk three. Yeah. Might have done that a couple times this fall.
It's true, though. And it's... Do you, I just want to ask you straight up, Spencer, do you talk to yourself a lot when you're by yourself?
No.
And you don't?
Nope.
Ever?
Nope.
You don't talk to yourself?
Let's talk about this, Grandy. Do you explain what you tell yourself?
Okay, hold on.
The only thing I talk to is a camera.
Seriously.
But I'm only saying when I say to a camera, it's what's running through my head. So like that dialogue kind of runs through my head a little bit, but most of the time, I guess I kind of think to myself where I'm trying to figure out, like, okay, they should be here based on all of these things. And if they're not here, then the next spot I'm going to go is here. And then the next spot I'm going to go is here. And then there'll be something I forgot through that progression of thought that'll come to me later on. And then I'll adjust everything I was doing.
Do you talk out loud?
No.
You just think it.
I just think.
Do you talk out loud?
I do.
Wow.
Do I talk out loud?
All the time.
Why do you say shit, though? It's like, it's not a bad thing.
I don't think
everybody does stuff different.
You
think out loud.
I think out loud. Yeah. I really do. And I probably shouldn't, because there's moments that I put my foot in my mouth, but I just say what I'm thinking. Not horrendously.
You're an external processor.
I would say so.
Thanks,
yes.
Dr. Bauer.
I would say so, yes. I am. But I do. What? You don't talk to yourself at all when you're fishing?
Not out loud.
In your head?
In my head, yeah.
Everybody talks to themselves while I'm fishing. I just say it out loud. I don't know. Is that weird? I'm by myself fishing.
I think your question to yourself, you've already answered that.
Yeah. Good point. Good point. Got any juicy questions on the docket?
From Kit?
Or anybody.
What's a juicy question?
I don't know.
I mean, how... Okay, he goes, what if your significant other says you need to cut back on fishing? What do you do?
I don't know if that's ever happened.
Yeah, it's happened.
Did it happen? Describe the situation that might have mentally blocked it out.
Well, this was like when we were trying to figure out, like, you know, the quality time stuff.
Yeah.
So, like, how much of that, like, us time we needed. Because I don't go fishing very often, so.
She never goes, ever.
So, you know, we're trying to, you know, both of us are really busy work-wise, so we're trying to figure out that sort of us quality time. So we were, like, when we were talking about that, we discussed fishing.
So we went down to the why. Like, why am I fishing too much? There has to be another reason, because it's impossible for me to be fishing too much. That was a joke.
Well,
why really is important. Like, why do you feel like I'm fishing too much?
Yeah, and we were just talking about, like, if we weren't together, you would be fishing more.
Oh, yeah.
So, like, you know, I am an obstacle.
Well, if you want to frame it in that way.
No, hold on. I know.
I mean, if you, like, just, you know, if we're being real.
If we're strictly talking about fishing a quantity of days or quantity of time on the water, you are absolutely an obstacle in that regard. But there's so much more to things beyond that.
Yeah, so, I agree.
So, like, I fish because fishing makes me happy, but I married you because you make me happy. So there has to be, like, some type of balance within those things. And that balance looks different for everybody. Mine just happens to be like 250 days on the water. So we have to figure out how to spend the other 113 some real quality time.
Hey, but those 150 days, a couple of those days with Ella too. So that's
just... All right. So yeah, we're up to like 115 days of quality time. To me, 115 is a lot.
That is a lot.
Yeah.
But it's, I mean, but the type of fishing you do, it's kind of necessary.
Spending large amounts of time on the water. Yeah. If you want to have real success.
That's what I'm saying, yeah.
Like, you can line up all the variables with flatheads and stuff you want, but the ultimate one is time on the water.
Yeah.
Like I said, this is the best year I've ever had. So as far as the number of fish caught per time invested, one fish per 6 hour means if you fish all night, on average, you're getting two. Feel pretty freaking good about that number.
This one's thinking like you ain't flat head fishing anytime soon, homie.
Honestly, all right. I'm going to sell flathead fishing to you. Are you ready, Hugh?
All right, here we go.
I'm ready.
Okay, you have to go. I'm selling it to you as if you are going.
Okay.
Okay, and it'll be tough right now because your youngest is two. It'd be doable in certain locations because you need a bank fishing spot. Yeah, you couldn't go to a place that's real far, but there are places where you can walk short distances, bank fish, and have a shot at a big flathead. Now, imagine this. You have several fishing poles. You have bait. You cast them out. You set the poles down, and then they're just in the water. You don't have to pay attention to them. You don't have to do anything. They're doing all the fishing for you. In the meantime, think of many of your other family activities that you do all together. And then whatever one of those that you can do outdoors, just do that. And then every once in a while, about once every 6 hours, if you're real good, you'll hear a clicker start rolling and then you go catch that fish. So you spent all this quality time together as a family while simultaneously fishing and having a shot at a 30, 40, 50 pound catfish.
We're going to have to try this because okay.
Do you go camping?
I love camping.
Well, there you go.
She's like you. Like you were just saying, she doesn't want to go fishing if we're just going to sit there for 6 hours, 7 hours just on a bank or whatever.
Fishing. You don't even have to look at the rods.
But if she goes camping, like you were just saying,
like
she
has. There's so many activities. Yeah. You can go hiking. You can go fishing. You can take a nap.
Yep.
Drink.
So she loves camping.
Napping and drinking. Actually help you catch more flatheads.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Any way to pass the time.
Hello, Spencer. Yeah. Hello, Spencer. He's working the magic right now.
Just you could hire me for $125 an hour.
There we go. Catch a flathead. I haven't caught a flathead yet. I have to do that.
Actually, I'm not $125 an hour. I'm under $100 an hour. Yeah.
Why are you so cheap?
I'm pretty cheap.
What if I just made you some pho?
Sold.
Sweet. It was delicious, by the way.
Yeah.
That's boom away.
I work for money, boom away, or pho. Like any of those three.
I'll just give you a pot.
And I put a little too much of that spicy stuff in it.
Oh, shit. You did?
Well, but it was still really good. Oh, but I was like... Everything was like running.
All
like,
the pores, I was like, all the noses.
I was like crying, and it was like so good.
I think I found a new best friend.
Well, you'll have to make pho for them.
Yes.
Because I promised him pho, but you gave him boom away, and then Kid was like, he was jealous, dude. You don't even know. He's like, man, where's mine, man?
Yeah.
Because he usually always gets it to go.
I usually pack him some.
Sorry, you guys got it. Sorry, Kit.
Sorry.
Happens, Kit, man. That's what happens when you're sick and can't be on a podcast.
This is true.
Just saying.
We're just talking about fishing a lot, and I was selling flathead fishing.
Do I fish too much? Honestly, be real. I'm curious. Do you think I fish too many days out of the year? Careful.
No, I don't think so, because I understand like you love fishing, but then you also need it for content. So I'm like, just go do whatever you need to do as long as the kids are taken care of, basically.
Good segue, bud. So that means I can go a little bit more, yeah?
You're pushing it, bud.
But she did mention about the content thing, so... I started recording myself fishing and then just the kids fishing and posting it, whatever, the videos. Do you record? Or, okay. Do you ever find yourself fishing to record?
Me? I just document the shit I was going to do anyway. That's the way I look at it. Like, I've always fished a lot, and I fish more now than I ever have, but now it is part of my job, and that is a wonderful excuse to go more. Actually, beyond that, it's just enabled my ability to go more. Because when you have a full-time separate job, then you're fishing around that, you still are limited on the amount of time because you have 40 to 50 hours that are taken up by your full-time job. So now I have those 40 to 50 hours that I can dedicate towards something else, and then I find myself on the water more often. But I don't necessarily feel like I'm fishing, like... I go fishing just to get content, just to get a video. I go because I really, really want to. I guess the more I think about it, there's been a few times where I've went fishing and I didn't feel like it, or the weather sucked, or I didn't feel like the odds were good, but I went anyway because I didn't have stuff to make a video. The benefit to that, I don't know, that what I was going to go to is irrelevant to the question. So I guess at times, yeah, I guess I have.
It's kind of
a shame to feel that way.
Well, I would say thanks, Spencer.
No, I'm not knocking what you're doing at all.
I don't feel ashamed. I just feel like...
It takes away from some of the purity of the fishing itself.
I agree with you on that one. That's why I told her, I go, every time I fish from now on, I just record. Like, you just never know. But I just, like you're just saying, like, I don't want to take away from the shit. You know what I'm saying? Like you're saying, the purity of it. I feel like it's sometimes I do and then sometimes I don't. I don't know. Does that make sense?
It does to me because I'm in a similar situation.
But then I'm at 200 something subscribers versus 80,000, so it's a little bit different. Yeah, I think I tried too hard.
The concept's the same.
True. I wouldn't say I tried too hard. I think I just like, God, I can't just post a video where I just got, I caught a shad.
If you caught a shad when you're fishing, that'd be cool. Yeah. They're vegetarians.
Now you tell me. Well, how about I snagged a shad?
Oh, okay. That's different.
Actually, I'm trying to think if I caught a shad. No, I snagged shads. But yeah, I was like, man, I can't post this. And it's like, shit, it sucks. So we're back. And FYI, my wife doesn't listen to any of my podcasts, which sucks. I just, my heart's broken. She goes.
Mine is for you, too.
She doesn't watch any videos or anything.
Only if it has the kids.
There we go. But as we were just kind of, you guys were just discussing about podcasts and everything. So just FYI, when you're driving, you can listen to River Certified Podcasts and you can listen to Beerfish Fanatics every time you drive.
It's true.
She drives for hours, dude.
Hours. She can.
I'm just saying.
But Elvis Duran is just so much more entertaining. That gay man.
Who's Elvis Duran?
Morning show guy.
Morning show host in New York. He's gay and does fabulous.
Does he fish?
No. Maybe that's why I love him.
What's gay have to do with anything?
Nothing. He's just fabulous.
But you brought it up. So it must be relevant to some degree if you had to bring it up.
I like him, Spencer.
Just saying.
I think he's funny. Is he?
He
funny?
Is very funny.
I don't know, man.
I've listened to him. He's pretty funny. Yeah.
I'm just saying, you can help support River Certified Podcast or Beerfish Fanatics when you're driving in Central Iowa. Just saying.
Or anywhere. In the world.
Anywhere.
You could be driving in like Egypt, listening to River Certified Podcast.
Just saying. But on another note, thank you so much for not talking too much. I don't know why. This is the most time I've heard my wife like quiet. Very rare.
We're good.
Yeah, thanks.
I
might have to loosen her up a little bit more next time. Oh God, that just came out. But, oh boy, I don't know if I'm going to edit that one out or not. I don't know.
I think you were trying to say you should give her another drink.
I think that's exactly what I was trying to say, but that just...
happens to me. I understand.
Thank you so much, Ella. Thank you so much, Spencer, for being on our podcast. I don't know. This is the thing. I really want to try something a little bit new, a little bit different, get the other side. Our listeners, if you guys like this one, let me know. We can get some other spouses. I think there's been a few others who've been talking to me that like, would want to jump on. But I'm just like, meh, we'll see.
I think we need... I mean, I feel like we're on the same page with how we feel about fishing. I think it'd
need
be interesting.
Conflicting opinion.
I think we need, yeah, because this was a little too, you know.
You guys are too easy. Yeah. I'm not going to lie.
You think this way? I think this way, too. Oh, we think the same way. That's nice.
Yeah, I agree. I mean,
I'm
sure you guys have had disagreements about fishing or whatever. So, yeah. I mean, but... it'd be interesting to have.
Does Kit have a girlfriend?
No.
He's looking for a girlfriend.
He's looking. So anyone's listening to
this? Please, we'll like and right. subscribe.
Wow, whoa. Hold on. You gotta like and subscribe. Don't get me wrong about that. But subscribing for... okay, let's do it. Let's,
for a date?
Yes. All right, everybody.
A fishing date with Kit.
We gotta get fishing Kit.
I might have to do a deal on my podcast to get Kit a date.
Yes. Single female.
He is single. I'm not gonna lie.
He's kind of small, short.
Whoa.
He's not that short.
All right.
But he's so nice and funny.
He's nice and funny. He's a nice
guy. Looking for a girlfriend.
He is. He is. How, I don't want to say how old he is, but.
Fishing ability.
He's younger than me.
He's not bad.
He's better than Grandy.
Wow. Yeah. Thanks, Mom.
Like, he's outfished me the last two times we've went fishing, so I can't talk too much trash.
All right, we should do that. No, you're right. All right, we got to make this an effort, a conscious effort to help him. I don't know if help
just
him.
Just a daily segment.
Yes.
Like, every time. It has to be a segment.
All right, that's it. Beerfish Fanatics. We're going to do segments. Hey, he dated anyone recently.
The Get Kit a Date segment.
Get Kit. Son of a gun.
And you can, like, point out his admirable qualities that would be, you know, intoxicating to significant other.
So if any ladies are listening right now, he is. He's really, he's funny.
He's nice.
He has a job.
He has a job.
Sweet car. He can bring home food.
There you go. Yes. He catches food for you. And he can cook.
Yes.
Well, shit.
Oh, gosh.
Sounds like a catch.
Why is he single?
Right.
I don't even know. I don't get it. Why is he single? All right. Listeners, I know you guys got to know some single girls here and there. Let's do it. Segment.
I wouldn't put my stamp of approval on Kit if I didn't think he deserved it.
Thank you.
Your River certified stamp.
Yeah. He's actually a really good kid.
Yeah.
I'm not going to lie. Like a genuine, shut up, kid. I know you're going to talk shit, but
you're getting way deep into this.
I'm getting too deep into this. But anyways, we're doing it anyway. So we'll do a kid segment. I like that. He's single.
What are you going to do when he gets a girlfriend?
I have no idea.
We'll cross that bridge when we get
there. Yeah, let's cross that bridge.
You ask me, I'll think of something.
All right, there we go. But other than that, thank you guys so much for just joining us. I want you guys to come back on again. Hopefully you guys had fun. Next time, I just want to know what people think of this, because I just want to hear others' opinions about the podcast, because we had other females who don't fish.
Yeah.
But I agree with you. Let's get another one who just despises fishing or something. Ooh. How am I going to find someone who despises fishing?
I'll find you one.
All right.
Maybe your listeners know something.
There we go. Listeners, if your wife or significant other or partner
I'm just laughing at the idea of getting somebody on the podcast who doesn't like fishing.
Dude.
And just see, like.
I'll do it. I'm down to do it.
I think it'll be tough to get that person on the podcast.
That's the only thing. Okay. So, anybody listening? Anybody that you know that just despises fishing?
And likes to talk.
Yeah. And I'm pretty sure there's plenty of them out there. Let me know. Love to give them on. We'll have a good time. We'll have drinks. If they're locally here, great. We can see in person. They might just take a swing. Oh, well. Because it's fishing. Whatever.
If I'm on it, I might have to roast them.
It'll be interesting. All right. Till next time, guys.